Hi, this is GBP 8KD, British pound versus Hong Kong dollar, and today it's Sunday, 8th of June 2014, before the markets open for the new trading week. I'm Sofia Stavropoulou, and this is a video case study for FXholic Forex Signals apps users. We are looking at the H4 time frame of the pair, and I'm using Ichimoku Kinkohio, Bollinger Bands, Fractals, a Bill Williams Indicator, and Stochastics. GBP8KD is the clone, is the identical twin of GBP USD. Pretty much what I'm going to present here is exactly what I'm going to present on the GBP USD signal or case study. Keep it in your mind that the two pairs are just like two drops of water. So the big picture is bullish, as we see on the weekly time frame, wildly bullish, and the corrective plans, the statistical validation plans down to the medium Bollinger band has already been done. The stochastics show that they are slightly angled, and these two candlesticks here, the bearish candlestick with the long tail and the bullish candlestick with the long tail, both balancing on the medium Bollinger band, show that there is a tendency for a bullish continuation, for the continuation of the uptrend. The medium Bollinger band is going upwards, it's sloping strongly upwards, and look at the body of the bullish Kumo, it's huge, and the vertical distance between the upper border, which is Seku span A, and the lower border, which is Seku span B, this vertical distance, which reflects momentum, shows that the bullish momentum is increasing, and this is huge. So let's go to the daily time frame, and because this is the best time frame to use for nice trade setups. We had a down fractal at the lower Bollinger band, confirmed by stochastics, which turned going upwards, and I will insert here a vertical line to see which was the relationship of the signals we got from the various tools. So we had the first down fractal here. Stochastics confirmed that the price wanted to go up, but it made this corrective plunge. It tested again the same level, creating a new fractal. While stochastics remained upwards, they kept their upward inclination, and now we had this very strong bullish candlestick, which confirmed the entry because it crossed and closed above Tenkan-sen Ichimoku Kinkohio red line. It closed above Tenkan-sen, so it gave us a nice buy entry on the daily time frame. But if you want the best way to go after you see this, after you see a fresh bullish price Tenkan-sen cross, it's to go to smaller time frames and use the 4 time frames Ichimoku setup that I'm presenting also on my book and on most of my signals. So when we see a fresh bullish price Tenkan-sen cross like the one here on the daily, we go to the H4 and wait to see a strong bullish Kumo breakout validated by Chiku Span, which is the green line of Ichimoku Kinkohio. And this bullish price this bullish Kumo breakout has not happened yet. Okay, so we wait to see the price going above the Kumo, But this is not enough. We also want to see this green line which is moving in the past, because Ichimoku Ginkgo here is a fantastic and very, very strong system. It works on the present, on the future, and in the past, and it's very powerful. So Chikuspan, the green line, is the element that is related to the past. And we want validation from Chikuspan, and this means that Chikuspan must be above past price action as it is, and also above the Kumo, which has not happened yet. Chikuspan will ideally go above the Kumo at this price level here, which will be at 13.0352 and above on GBP HKD. So we expect when the price will go this level, maybe one or two candlesticks later, we will have our second condition met. When we see a strong bullish Kumo breakout validated by Chikuspan on H4, we go to H1, we want to see everything bullish, which is not now, and then we go to M30 on the condition that all we described has happened already. Bullish Kumo breakout on H4 validated by Chikuspan, 100% bullish picture on H1. Then we come to M30 and we look for something like this, a bearish correction. We want to see a bearish price Tenkan-sen cross, a bearish candlestick crossing and closing below Tenkan-sen, and then the price moving downwards. And when we see it going upwards again, and we see a bullish price Tenkan-sen cross on M30, we enter from M30, we enter long, we buy, and we continue the trend. Two take profit targets, depending on your profile as a trader. If you are a conservative trader, a long-term trader, a patient trader, you will go for the Kumo entry, Kumo breakout entry, Kumo breakout exit. What does it mean? We enter practically after a bullish Kumo breakout, so theoretically and ideally we should exit after a bearish Kumo breakout happens on the same time frame, which is H4. But if you are not so patient, and if you are not such a type of trader, and you are more aggressive or more impatient and more you want speed, go to M30, which is the smallest time frame, the one from which you will enter, and use the price Tenkan-sen cross criterion to enter, exit, wait, and re-enter. What do I mean by that? Since the main trend of the pair is upward, when we ride the trend for as long as we see an upward move, and when we see a bearish price Tenkan-sen cross on M30, we exit, we wait for the correction, we enter again with the bullish price Tenkan-sen cross, and when we see a bearish price Tenkan-sen cross, we exit again, we wait for the correction, and when we see a bullish price Tenkan-sen cross, we enter long, we ride the trend, and we exit when we see a bearish price Tenkan-sen cross. So we enter and exit on price Tenkan-sen crosses. Thanks for watching and happy pips.